Let's say we're asked to simplify this expression and leave our answers with positive exponents. We start by rearranging the terms in the numerator. While the denominator can stay the same, there is no rearrangement necessary there. We're doing this so that we collect all the numbers together, all the x's together, and all the y's together. So 4 times 3 will give us the 12. X to the negative 5th times x cubed will give us x to the negative 2. By the product rule, since the bases are same and we're multiplying the two expressions, we add the exponents. Negative 5 plus 3 gives us negative 2. Lastly, with y to the negative 3 times y to the negative 2, we use the same product rule expression. Since the bases are same and we're multiplying the terms, we add the exponents. Negative 3 plus negative 2 gives us y to the negative 5. The denominator stays identical. Now, since there is nothing that can be simplified in the numerator by itself or in the denominator by itself, we can use the quotient rule. 12 divided by 6 will give us a 2. Now, anytime negatives are involved with the quotient rule, I always recommend students write the expression out because it's very simple to make a mistake on here. Note that bases are same and we're dividing, so we have to take the difference of the exponents, but the expression is always top power minus bottom power. So the negative 2 stays on top minus the bottom power, negative 5. Similarly here, for the y's, we have y raised to the negative 5 minus 3, top power minus bottom power. Now, cleaning this up, a negative times a negative is positive, so this really is just negative 2 plus 5. Negative 5 minus 3 is going to give us negative 8. Now, this can be simplified further to give us 3. So the answer is, as of right now, 2 times x to the third times y to the negative 8. The question requires us to give our answer with positive exponents because there are no other rules or properties of exponents that can be used here. The 2 already has a positive exponent of 1. The x already has a positive exponent of 3. It's only the y that has a negative exponent that we don't want. So all we would need to do is apply the negative power rule to just the term that needs to move. If we move the y to the negative 8 to the denominator, the sign on the power will flip and we'll get 2x cubed over y to the 8th. That answer has all positive exponents, as the question asked for.